Hey everyone. I asked someone who is not an artist to draw this picture. Then I took this image and fed it into Stable Diffusion, which is an AI model you can actually download and run on your computer. This is what it generated after just 3 iterations, with me choosing the best result at each step and then feeding it back in. This is really incredible technology, and there are 2 things that I want to highlight that really set Stable Diffusion apart from its predecessors like DALL-E and Midjourney. The most important thing to me is that you can go out and download Stable Diffusion right now and run it on your own computer. You'll need an NVIDIA video card with 4 gigs of GPU memory. Don't confuse that with your CPU memory. They're separate. And you'll need some advanced installation skills. This is not as simple as installing WinRAR, but it's doable. The other thing that I found really cool is the pre-made script that generates images based off another image. This is different from DALL-E, where you can erase an image and regenerate that area. The image-to-image script that comes with Stable Diffusion actually uses the entire input image as a starting point for the generation. That means you can draw a rough drawing of what you want and have the AI give you its own rendition of it. Other than that, they work pretty similarly. You write a human-readable description of what you want, wait a few seconds, and look through the generated results to see if they're any good. It does feel a little weird to be using the names of real, living people whose art has been scraped and fed into a machine that mimics their style, but hey, don't shoot the messenger. Here's some creepy weirdness going on. There have been already some really interesting uses of this. On the R Stable Diffusion subreddit, someone is taking screenshots from old video games and turning them into what looks like high-res concept art. And I've personally tried making Minecraft screenshots into landscape photos. For certain types of images, it works really well. For others, not so much. This, of course, is Luke Skywalker about to fight a dinosaur, and the algorithm just isn't really good with anatomy in general. Basically, these latent diffusion models are trained to denoise an image that has had noise artificially added in multiple steps. Once it's been trained to denoise any image by one step, you can let it extrapolate from a purely noisy image. It's all explained in this paper, and I'm sure you can find plenty of in-depth explanations of it out there, but this iterative denoising process explains how we can generate images from a starting image. In the model, the strength parameter controls how much noise is added to the image. If we add only a little noise, the result is pretty similar to the initial image. If we add a lot of noise, we get something very different. Like, what is even going on here? If you're interested, definitely give it a shot. And if you don't have a computer that can run it, or don't want to deal with the hassle of installing it, there are plenty of places online where you can try it out. As always, you can find links and more details in the description below. And if you found this video interesting, the best thing that you can do is to share it with someone else and spread the knowledge. Thanks for watching. See you next time.